Hello. Today I'm going to talk about the three-level buck converter technology found at the heart of BQ25910, TI's latest companion fast charger for single-cell battery applications with up to 5% efficiency improvement. This translates to a 50% increase in charge current for a fixed power loss budget. In addition to increasing efficiency, this converter is able to reduce the solution size in half by using a smaller, low-profile inductor. There are two key criteria that define the performance of a battery charger: charging efficiency and solution size. Higher efficiency means higher charge current and shorter charge times, but it's typically achieved by increasing the size of the circuit. The three-level buck converter allows for a reduction in size while increasing the overall efficiency. The BQ25910 is based on a three-level buck converter, which adds a flying capacitor, C-fly, and a couple of switches to the traditional topology. By maintaining the flying capacitor balance at half the input voltage, the switch node can be presented with VIN, VIN over 2, or ground, hence the name, three-level converter. When the input voltage is higher than twice the output voltage, the switch node alternates between ground and VIN over 2. In comparison, when the input voltage is lower than twice the output voltage, the switch node alternates between VIN and VIN over 2. Now let's look at how the switches are driven for each of these scenarios. Imagine a 12-volt input used to charge a 4-volt battery. In this case, the converter would operate by alternating the switch node between VIN over 2 and ground, as shown here. The cycle consists of four stages. We start the cycle with Q1 and Q4 on, presenting VIN minus VFLY, in other words, VIN over 2, at the switch node. At the same time, the C-fly capacitor gets charged while the inductor gets energized because the output is lower than the switch node voltage. During the second stage, Q1 is turned off and Q2 is turned on, bringing the switch node to ground. This leaves the C-fly capacitor disconnected and de-energizes the inductor. In the third stage, the controller turns off Q4 and turns on Q3, connecting the C-fly capacitor directly across the switch node. This has the effect of discharging the capacitor voltage and energizing the inductor current. It is important to note that whatever charge was added to C-fly during the first stage should be removed from C-fly during the third stage in order to maintain the capacitor balanced at VIN over 2 in steady state operation. Finally, the fourth stage turns off Q3 and turns Q4 back on, connecting the switch node directly to ground. This leaves the capacitor disconnected and de-energizes the inductor once again, in preparation for the next cycle. As the input voltage decreases, the controller automatically increases the duration of stages 1 and 3, in other words, increases the duty cycle, in order to maintain a regulated output voltage. This has the effect of reducing the inductor current ripple until a minimum is reached when the input is exactly equal to twice the output. At this point, the switch node remains at VIN over 2 all the time, while the controller changes between stage 1 and stage 3 in order to charge and discharge the flying capacitor each cycle. As the input voltage continues to decrease, the controller continues to increase the duty cycle until Q1 and Q3 are turned on during the same time period. In this case, the switch node starts alternating between VIN and VIN over 2. Again, there's always a stage where the flying capacitor is charged and one where it is discharged. We can now think about a low input voltage like 5 volt charging a 4 volt battery. Similar to the previous example, the controller alternates between charging the capacitor, disconnecting it, then using the capacitor as a supply, and finally leaving it disconnected again. Two clear benefits can be derived from the three-level converter waveforms discussed. First, reduced voltage stress across the inductor and the switches during all operating modes. And second, switching frequency doubling at the switch node. These two combine to reduce the maximum inductor current ripple by 4x when compared to a buck converter. Current ripple is used to select an inductance value, so reducing it enables the use of smaller, low-profile inductors. Additionally, the coil resistance is a function of inductance, so reducing it will also reduce the power losses. Finally, the switches in the three-level only need to block half the input voltage, reducing the switching loss associated with their transitions. These benefits combine to provide a 5% higher charging efficiency while reducing the solution size by half. Now you know how the flying capacitor and extra switches in the BQ25910 work to increase the efficiency and reduce solution size for high current charging. If you want to learn more, visit the link below. Thanks for watching.